Hey guys, this is Aman Thakur and you are watching me on this YouTube channel. So today in this video, I'm going to discuss with you a very important topic of organic chemistry. It's called Markovnikov rule and anti-Markov. So in this video, beta, we will see ki why we are studying about this Markovnikov and anti-Markov. Right? To see. Markovnikov and anti-Markovnikov rule helps us beta to finding out the major product of addition reactions between unsymmetrical alkenes and halogen acids. Means in a simple way, if I say beta, whenever we react an alkene, right, that must be an unsymmetrical alkene with an halogen acid. So, कौन सा प्रोडक्ट मेजर अमाउंट में फॉर्म होगा राइट दैट वी कैन कैलकुलेट यू कैन से डिटरमाइन बाय द यूज ऑफ मार्कोवनिकोव एंड एंटीमार्कोव ओके सी सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस टॉपिक बेटा वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज अनसिमेट्रिकल एल्कीन एंड व्हाट आर हैलोजन एसिड्स राइट मींस व्हाट आर अनसिमेट्रिकल एल्कीन्स Right, and what are symmetrical alkenes? Right, see if I just write beta, very simple molecule, it is ethene. Right, so we know ethene, the formula of ethene is what? CH2 double bond CH2 right beta so see beta if I just cut this molecule right from the mid of this molecule so it will generate two equal parts right beta two equal parts on the both side of this line so if I cut this molecule now so this will you can say create two equal parts so this kind of alkene beta is called symmetrical alkene right we can also take another example if I just write CH3 single bond CH double bond CH CH3 right so if I just cut beta this molecule from the middle so again it will cut into two half and both the parts beta are symmetrical right so we can say again this is an symmetrical alkene right what will be its name beta so butene right first one is ethene so we can say if by cutting the molecule beta into two halves if it will create two equal parts na so that alkene beta must be considered as symmetrical alkene right means kisi alkene ko beech mein se cut karne par agar wo same parts ko form kar rahi hai so that alkene is called symmetrical alkene getting my point okay so beta we can also define the symmetrical alkenes means those alkenes which have similar groups on both sides of the carbon-carbon double bond. Right? We can say symmetrical alkenes are those alkenes, beta, only two symmetrical groups are attached on the both sides of the carbon-carbon double bond. Right? And if I take, beta, see other example, a propene, again very simple molecule. So what will the formula? CH3CH2, right, beta? So if I cut, beta, this molecule on the mid, right, so it will not create, beta, two symmetrical parts, right? So in this case, beta, we can say this will be an unsymmetrical alkene. Right, this will be an unsymmetrical alkene, you can see, right? And if I just take another example, beta, see C H double bond C, and just writing, beta, two CH3 groups. So this kind of alkene, beta, again, if we just cut this into half, so it will also not create two similar groups, right, on the both side. So again, this will also considered as unsymmetrical alkene, right, beta? Means symmetrical alkenes are those, right, beta, on which on the both side, right, beta, two symmetrical groups are present, right? And unsymmetrical are those, beta, on which again on the both side of the carbon-carbon double bond, beta, two unsymmetrical groups are there, right? So we can say unsymmetrical alkenes are those, beta, on which different groups are attached to carbon-carbon double. Okay, on the both side of the carbon-carbon double. Getting? So see, Markovnikov rule, beta, tell us that whenever we take an unsymmetrical alkene and it's reacted with halogen acids. So see, what are halogen acids, beta? Generally represented as HX. This is a general representation of halogen acids, right? And where your X may be chlorine, fluorine, bromine, and iodine, right, beta? So these may be your halogen acids. Okay. So see, now if I take an example, CH3, CH, CH2. This is propene, right? And we know propene is an unsymmetrical alkene, right? Why? Because if I cut this molecule, beta, into two half, so again it will not create two similar groups. Okay, so this is an example of unsymmetrical alkene. So beta, if I just react with this molecule with HBr, this is an halogen acid, right? So what will be the products? So see, beta, there will be two products from CH3, CH, Br, CH3. Another one is CH3, CH2, CH2, Br, right? So they are two products, beta, and we know one of these two, beta, will be major and another will be minor, right? So beta, it was observed that if this product, right, that is, name it 1, 2, 3, 2-bromo-propane. Right, was a major product, beta. It was found that it was a major product, and the second one you can also write its name 1, 2, 3, 1-bromo-propane, राइट, दिस वॉज द माइनर प्रोडक्ट. सो वाई बेटा, टू ब्रोमो प्रोपेन वॉज ऑब्जर्व एज मेजर एंड वेयर एज वन ब्रोमो प्रोपेन एज माइनर प्रोडक्ट, राइट. सो वी कैन आंसर दिस बेटा बाय द यूज ऑफ मार्कोवनिकोव रूल. ओके, सो सी, देखते हैं और कैन बी पॉसिबल. सो बेटा, टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इट्स मैकेनिज्म. ओके, सो बेसिकली दिस रिएक्शन बेटा प्रोसीड्स वाया इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक एडिशन रिएक्शन. ओके, मीन्स योर अनसिमेट्रिकल एल्केन रिएक्ट्स विद योर हैलोजन एसिड्स, राइट बेटा, बाय यू कैन से इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक एडिशन रिएक्शन. ओके, नाउ सी, सो व्हाट इज मार्कोवनिकोव. लेट्स फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड दिस, राइट, देन वी कम ऑन टू द मैकेनिज्म. ओके, सो बेटा देयर वाज अ साइंटिस्ट, अ रशियन साइंटिस्ट, राइट, मार्कोवनिकोव बेटा वाज अ रशियन साइंटिस्ट. He was a chemist, right? Russian scientist. So, beta, he studied about these reactions, right? And on the basis of studies, beta, he find out a general conclusion, right, beta? Means you can say, it states that, right, the negative part the negative part of the addendum and what is addendum beta, addendum is the adding molecule which are going to be added, right, the negative part of the addendum, that is adding molecule, right beta, will attach to that carbon atom which has beta lesser number of hydrogen atoms. Getting my point? Hydrogen atoms. Means simply beta, Markovnikov states that his rule, right, on the basis of his studies, right, that the negative part of the addendum, what is addendum? The adding molecule, right, which is going to be added, right, will attach to the carbon atom which has less number of hydrogen atoms, right. So, in this case, beta, we can say what will be our addendum? Our addendum is beta, our halogen acids, that is HX. Okay. This is our addendum which is going to be added, right. So, if I just write na beta, this molecule can just break this bond. So, it will convert into H plus ion plus X minus ion. Right, so this will be the negative part and this will be the positive part. So you can say this will be negative part of the addendum, right, and this will be positive part of the addendum, right beta. So according to Markovnikov rule beta, this negative part of the addendum, right beta, will attach to that carbon atom that contain lesser number of hydrogen of the alkene. Okay, see, what does it mean? So, if I write beta CH3 CH2. This is again an unsymmetrical alkene. Its name is propene. Right? So see, beta, I just write this reaction, the reaction of this alkene. Right? With HBr. Right? Now I'm taking an actual example. So we know beta HBr. In this case, Br has negative charge and it will have positive charge. Right? So see beta, what will happen in this case? We can see, just count the beta number of atoms. If I just draw this structure, right, by expanding it, this is carbon-carbon double bond, right? So there will be a thiol group, that is CH3, CH, H, H, right? Means this carbon beta is representing this one, 1, this is carbon 1, and this is 2, this is 2 carbon. Right, so of the carbon beta atom 2, there are two groups. One is methyl, that is CH3, and other one is simple H atom. Right, but only one, there are two hydrogen. Okay, so just count the beta number of atoms on 1 and 2 carbon atom. Okay, so beta is, we can see clearly beta on the carbon atom, that is indicated by number 1. How many hydrogen atoms are there? There are beta on the first carbon. 2 hydrogen atoms, right? So we can say on the first carbon atom beta there are 2 hydrogen atoms which are attached, and on the second beta carbon, see, there is only 1 carbon hydrogen atom, right? There is only 1 hydrogen atom, right? Means you will consider only this. So we have to just see beta the hydrogen atom which is directly attached to carbon-carbon double, right? Means this hydrogen is directly attached to this carbon atom. Okay, and these two hydrogen beta are directly attached to this carbon atom. So we will not consider these hydrogens because these three hydrogen beta are not attached directly with the carbon of carbon-carbon double, right? So we can say here the carbon, that is beta 2, has lesser number of hydrogen atom as compared to the one, because on carbon 1 beta there are 2 hydrogen atom, and on carbon atom the number adds 2, there are only 1 hydrogen. Okay, so see, according to Markovnikov rule beta, what will be the major product in this case? See beta, again definition, the negative part of the addendum, that is adding molecule, will attach to the carbon atom which has lesser number of hydrogen, right? And our addendum is beta in this case HBr, right? And the negative part of this addendum is, will be Br minus. Okay, so this Br minus beta will attach to the carbon that has lesser number of hydrogen. So in this case we can see beta very clearly, this is the carbon which has only 1 hydrogen atom, right? That is carbon 2. Okay, so if I just write its product beta, CH3 CH, so this is the carbon beta. Right, so I just write here Br and CH3, and the another will be CH3 CH2 Br. Right, so see beta, this is the carbon in this case 2, right? I'm just writing, this is the carbon 2, right, and this is the carbon 1. So beta, in this case we just attach this Br minus, right, negative part of the addendum to second carbon, and in the second case this Br minus attached to first carbon. So beta, according to Markovnikov, this will be the major product and this will be minor product. Okay, so you have to just attach beta the negative part of the addendum, that is your HBr halogen acid, to that carbon atom of the double bond that contains lesser number of hydrogen. So that will be your major product. Okay, now see beta, why does so happen, right? So we will see this thing will happen, right, by the use of its mechanism. Okay, so see beta, now again I'm just taking same molecule, that is propene, CH3 CH double bond and CH2. Okay, so it will react beta. First with H plus ion of the HBr, right beta? Means this HBr beta will dissociate into H plus ion and will give Br minus ion, right? So beta, this will be the first step in which this double bond attacks this proton. Okay, so this thing will happen in two ways. I'm just writing this carbon 1, this will be 2, right? So this beta hydrogen get attached to here to second carbon. I'm just writing carbon 2 and here carbon 1, right? Means this hydrogen get attached to beta H plus ion, in this case second carbon, and in this case first carbon, right? So what will be the product? See, CH3, if it will attach to beta second carbon, so C it will get attached here, CH, and this bond will break and this will convert into CH2 plus, right? And carbocation will form, and in this case beta CH3 we have to attach to the carbon 1, so this will remain as a CH and it will form a carbon, right beta, positive ion. Again this will become CH2 and one more hydrogen, so you can write directly CH3. Okay, so beta, by adding this H plus ion to double bond, there will be two carbocation form, right? And we know beta, we can easily find out if this carbocation is primary carbocation. Why it is primary? Because this carbon beta is directly attached to only single carbon, right? Only one carbon atom. So this will be primary carbocation, and in this case we can easily find out if this carbon which has positive charge is directly attached to beta to another carbon atoms. So this will be our secondary carbocation. Right? And we know beta that secondary carbocations are more stable as compared to the primary carbocations, right? So we can say this will be less stable, right? And why primary are less stable and secondary are more stable beta? This is due to plus I effects, right? So in this case beta, you can see if there is only one methyl group, that is this CH3, right? So here is only one CH3 group which stabilizes this carbocation by plus I effect, right? And there are beta two methyl groups, right? So again there will be plus I effect. Okay, so there will be two CH3 groups, okay, which stabilize this carbocation. So secondary carbocation beta more stable as compared to first. So in this reaction beta, you can see two carbocations are formed. First is primary and another is secondary, and we know secondary carbocations are more stable as compared to primary, right beta? So now we can conclude beta, secondary carbocation being more stable, right, form predominantly right, means secondary carbocation being more stable beta, we can say they will form predominantly, means as compared to the primary carbocation beta, secondary carbocation will form in measure, right, or you can say form at faster rate also. Okay, means rate of this beta formation of secondary carbocation will be more as compared to the primary. Okay, Now, so this will be our major product. You can say major, intermediate in this ratio, right? Now, what will happen? This carbocation form beta CH3 positive charge, right? This is secondary carbocation. Right, this will beta undergo a nucleophilic right reaction, addition reaction, right? Means this will, this bromide ion beta right will attack this carbocation, right, and it will form CH3, and this Br will get attached to here. Okay, so this will be, in this case we can say 1, 3, 2 bromo propane will be our major product, right? Why it is major? Because secondary carbocation beta, we know, is more stable as compared to the primary, and it will form predominantly with a faster rate, right, beta? So then beta bromine ion will attack right to this carbocation, and it will convert into alkyl halide. It is 2 bromo pentane. Okay, so we can beta now clearly see in this reaction, right, means when an unsymmetrical alkene reacts with an halogen acid beta, right? So it will form 2 products, and one of these major. So the alkyl halide beta, you can say in this case, the second, right? This Br group attached to this second carbon, right, beta? So this will be major as compared to the bromine, which is attached to the carbon 1, right? So this is according to Markov's law. Okay. I hope I am clear. Okay, so finally beta, we can conclude right what this Markovnikov addition reaction proceeds via beta secondary carbo cation intermediate. Okay, means Markovnikov addition reaction beta proceeds via secondary carbocation intermediate. Okay, so this will be the major product of this Markovnikov addition reaction. Okay, so now I'm just giving you few questions beta. We will find out A and B, right, and which will be minor and which will be major. The second case, in this case, you have to just write the major product. Okay, so see beta, in this just find out which carbon atom which has less number of hydrogen beta. So we can clearly see this one, there is only one carbon atom, this carbon, right beta. So what will be the major product? CH3CHClCH3, right? This will be A, and we can say this will be major product, right? And minor will be CH3CH2, and this Cl beta will attach to the terminal carbon, right? Cl. So this will be our minor product, right? That is 2-chloropropane and this is 1-chloropropane. Okay, now come out to the second beta. So beta, if you expand this structure now, so you can easily understand. So beta, in this structure, just see, on this carbon atom beta, right, there is 0 hydrogen atom which is directly attached to this carbon atom. Why? Because there are beta 2 methyl group that is directly attached to this carbon atom, right? And on this carbon atom beta, there is 1 hydrogen atom, right? So as compared to the 0, 1 will be more, right beta, greater. So in this case, what will be the product? Means this Cl beta will get attached to that carbon which has lesser number of hydrogen atoms. So it will attach to this carbon, right? So in this case, what will be the major product? I can directly write CH3, right? CH, C is writing in this way, CH3, and this Cl, HCl. Okay, so this will be our major product. And you can also write its name, right? So I can write its name beta 1, 2, 3, 4. Its name will be 2-chloro, right? 2-methyl butane. Okay, so this will be the major product. So as you can see, the secondary carbocation will be more stable, right beta? So this reaction proceeds via secondary carbocation intermediate. Okay, so that's why beta, in case of unsymmetrical alkene, right, you can say this case 2-bromopropane will be the major as compared to the 1-bromopropane. Okay, so this is our mechanism.